fly with me. Let's fly away. I love Luke. Fly with me, let's fly away.
For passengers and staff, hand luggage causes more arguments than almost anything else. But it's not always about size, it's also about what's inside.
Yeah, that's true.
At Liverpool Airport, a woman who's flown in from Paris on her way to Malaga for a holiday has been pulled over by security.
Security! Sorry, that car cannot go on that flight.
The problem
is that
cat
is very
frightening
yeah.
For old cats,
bush cats,
and EasyJet
doesn't
like cats.
We don't like cats, no.
Ash
just, nope. No cats allowed.
Even though EasyJet doesn't allow any pets on any flight, Delphine Romero thought nothing of smuggling Koshka.
I'm smuggling cats in. Like, oh, I'm not going to be put cat, what? One. You could have smuggled a dog in, or a rat. No, I'm not. Don't do it. Or a guinea pig, or anything. But don't do it. For them. Yeah, let's watch it. Yeah.
So,
no cats.
Well
then, it's 2019. You shouldn't know it. It's like ages old. But yeah, do not do it again. If you don't, well, you get arrested. Yeah. Don't do it. What? You haven't got a passport? What is it? What's the airline? Hang on. Where's the airline? Yeah, I'm not available. It's the airline! Oh, we don't even have a passport. Yeah, the Queen cannot, but you can. You need one. No allowed on the airline.
Nobody told me anything for the cat. And I used to take my cat everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere.
Here, I don't want the cat. I'm on the flight.
Horrible. Well, if you use, I'll just take
she may be laughing now, but the situation is about to take a turn.
You can't be gone.
I'm
not being able. Hang on. Can you take it shopping as well? I'll get my phone. No, no. Is that a cat with blind citizens? Yeah, I can see it. I can see it, actually.
Delphine is having none of it. There's no way she's going to allow Koshka to go into quarantine.
The easiest
way out is to make a run for it, but Supervisor Leanne Chung is hot on Koshka's tail. Supervisor
go, mate!
Jones is
huge Christmas parties. It's not like any other company I've ever worked for before. They are big, they're massive, and everyone does make a huge effort. And the theme is like a mask ball. So all ladies have to have little masks. So I don't really know what we're supposed to have, but I thought I'd best make an effort and do smart.
As the jeans come off, Leo admits that tonight he's dressing to impress one lady in particular, his ex-girlfriend.
I've been going out for about 4 months. It's been quite stressful because she's just been promoted. She works for EasyJet's cabin crew. So she's been promoted and we've had a bit of a barney the last couple of days. So I'm hoping it with festivities and a little bit to drink. It might be on the upside and we might get back together. Hopefully.
It's cost him £65. Tonight he'll find out if it's money well spent.
Hey, gate, mate.
In Liverpool Airport's car park, Delphine Romero and Kat Koshka have been cornered by supervisors Sarah.
Can't be worse, can it?
She was just like swearing at me in French and telling me to go away basically. She ran all the way up there. I mean, I don't.
She's going,
she's got no car here, so...
She didn't walk to her, right?
She's
going on
the boat.
Jemaine has finally decided to turn herself in, but she's not about to come quietly.
Look at this, yeah. Wow, it looks very great. Well, it looks very great. You are a cat now. Cat's going, sorry, but your cat's gone. That is ridiculous, sorry. Today! Too much today! Yeah, it is. Too much today!
Yo, yo, yo! Yo, yo!
Yo!
Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo! Yo!
Yeah. And like no documents. Everyone's laughing. I'll be even worse. Oh, you just kept. Oh, you kept your suitcase. That's gonna be fun.
Despite the performance, Delphine and Koshka aren't going anywhere.
Oh, Koshka's gone. This country's a right place. You should have. I would have just saved it at home. I'll ask some other. What you call it?
Calls in experts from Merseyport Health Authority. They'll have to take Koshka away.
Koshka. Kennels. She'll be hitting him. I'm sorry, but she might be hitting him. Boy, dear man.
Has arrived to talk with Delphine, who's now been confined with Koshka to the calmer surroundings of the airport prayer room.
The lady's going to have to pay for the cab to be taken back to France. The authorities back to France to ensure it gets there, or it goes into quarantine. She's got a choice of either.
But neither option's going to be cheap, and it's still not clear who's to blame.
She showed it on check-in.
It seems it's all down to the airport staff in Paris, who allowed Koshka on the plane.
I'm just like you slide.
We'll say, yeah, we're
going
to pay for it to go back.
Yeah, it's in the room. They keep it until tomorrow, and they pay everything for me, and for the cab, and for the custom, and for everything. And they will send me the cab by plane.
Koshka, yeah. Her holiday in Malaga to return to Paris and await Koshka's safe return.
He's scared of it. Ah, you just got away with me.
Meanwhile, a reluctant Koshka is about to spend the first night of her holiday in the local kennel.
Okay, robbed.
As Delphine returns to France, one piece of hand luggage short, Koshka prepares for a lonely night away from her own. It's the evening of the Christmas ball.
Yeah.
We start by hitting the bar early at Luton Airport.
I'll just let slide on.
I just see us all dressed up. Good evening.
Meanwhile, Dawn Vernon is having a crisis with the Belfast flights.
Merry Christmas.
Awful. Useless. Inefficient. Would you like me to slate myself anymore?
Yep.
An earlier delay means the two evening flights to Belfast have had to be combined, and passengers are fast losing their festive spirit.
Oh my gosh,
this is...
I love this.
It's been really ridiculous.
It's ridiculous a lot. Is anyone there? Oh, it's ridiculous. Yeah, we know, it's busy. It's packed.
Vinette Cowan is a Tina Turner impersonator.
Yeah.
Her problem is she's due on stage in Belfast before the plane even lands.
Oh, what? Do I have to tell you? Should I really? I'm going to tell you. This is mine. I'll tell you. First, get there 3 years earlier. No, not 2 hours. More like an hour. No, get 2 years earlier. Not later. Not 3 hours later. Earlier. Please? Yeah. And get it done. It might take you off now, but at least you've got 2 hours and you can just wait. That'll be a great time. You don't. That'll be even better. Yeah.
And while Leo heads off to the ball, Dawn is left to make sure Tina Turner will hit the stage in Belfast tonight.
The only way we can leave Belfast before 10 o'clock is if you go out to Stansted. You've got an hour to get there. The only way is down by taxi.
EasyJet's merger with Go means the airline now flies from Stansted too. But Vinette has to travel 40 miles to get there, and she has to pay for the taxi herself.
I shouldn't have to be doing that, I mean, we've done as much as we can at the moment, and then if we actually do it so that you'd like to...
It's a little alias, it's a map on, isn't it?
I'm
A standstill in an hour could be pushing it.
You think you're going to make your performance or not?
Well, if I don't, I know where to come. I know where the buck will stop, really. Because I know if I miss my flight.
The taxi that was called for Vinette hasn't arrived.
Oh, well.
Pressure's now on Dawn to find another.
How much would you charge for Stansted? 50. I've got just under an hour to get there, and for them to rush me through like the superstar that I'm not. I am.
I'm superstar. I'm going to get that early.
Right, gentlemen, here's going to pick you up. I've asked him, he's going to drive as fast as he possibly can
without
a new...
Okay?
We got aliens! Just become Stansted, please.
The net is finally on her
that's
way
speed.
To becoming...
This feels...
Wait, wait, wait,
wait, wait.
London,
I'll let this slide.
And is relying on good old Dutch courage to help him win back his ex-girlfriend, Mel. One thing's for certain tonight, there won't be an inch of EasyJet Orange in the house. Leo's banking on this dapper new look impressing Mel. But it doesn't seem to be working yet.
Come on,
do
it.
Leo met Mel only a couple of months ago. And Mel's obviously extremely beautiful, very lovely girl. And Leo said, I haven't got a chance. And I said, let's just go for it. And they hit it off.
Probably.
But will Leo need more than Cupid's arrow to win Mel back?
Yay.
It's Christmas Eve in Luton.
Christmas
Tomorrow
Eve!
Yay! Closed, so any passengers who missed their flights today won't be going anywhere till Boxing Day.
Yeah, I understand.
Sorry,
dude.
Meet tomorrow.
A passenger stuck in traffic has phoned and is pleading for more time.
The check-in closes in 6 minutes. She's not gonna make it.
No, she's not gonna make it.
And she started saying to me, like, she's gonna see her boyfriend for only 2 days if we can only put her on Boxing Day. Unfortunately, our flight, this is the last flight to Athens with us before Christmas. So I've said to her she can come and she can try, but we can't make any guarantees.
The Athens flight has started loading and the check-in has closed. The passenger who phoned in has only just arrived.
Okay, and where is your mum? Can she bring them in? Because I'm going to try and get you on the flight, but I need to know how many bags you've got.
Two.
Okay, so I'll get your mum and your bag.
It seems Christmas in Athens with her boyfriend is still on the cards for Shireen. That's if someone can find her and her mum.
I'm going to go and try and see if I can see her, because they're going to get her on the flight. Because dispatch haven't had any figures yet, so if I can find her and rush her, I can get her on it.
Mum's disappeared to park the car and she's taken Shireen's cases with her. So although Shireen will be spending Christmas with her boyfriend, his presence will be staying behind. In Liverpool, it's not a last-minute passenger Joanne Dempsey is trying to get onto a flight, but a very important piece of jewellery.
And your son's going home for Christmas, girlfriend Marie's been going there for about 12 months.
Sure.
And your girls are supposed to get engaged. We were late coming out and dropped all the stuff and run down, and they forgot to bring the ring with them. Hopefully we're going to get it on then.
But the ring still has to be security checked before it can be reunited with his son Andrew, who's already boarded the Belfast flight. Joanne's hoping to appeal to the dispatcher's romantic nature to get the ring on board.
Well, he's proposing tomorrow on Christmas Day, so we need to get it on. Danny
Chung,
come on, it's Christmas, open the door.
Yeah, it's Christmas, come on. I'm screaming, you know.
Okay,
all right,
Danny's going to bring it out now.
With the doors closed, the only way to get the ring onto the aircraft is through the cockpit window.
It's all right, now be out there. Tomorrow morning.
As far as Joanne is concerned, the ring is winging its way to Belfast. By now, Shireen should be boarding, but she's desperate to get her luggage on a later flight to Athens.
My mum decided to go and park.
Okay. We don't carry bags on their own, would we?
We don't normally, no.
No, they wouldn't do it.
answer's no. So Mum has finally turned up with the missing luggage.
Go on.
She's got her bags, but has she missed her flight? The bags have been accepted.
Yeah, you made it. Yes, please like, subscribe. I'll see you soon. Merry Christmas if you're liking it. I'll do a part 2. Bye.